Greetings, Guardians. My name is Bife here. So it's time to talk about Savathûn for a bit. This isn't going to be the big Savathûn roundup that's coming later, because it's just frankly bigger than most other videos that I've done. I honestly expect this to be at least a little longer than the roundup for the Exo Stranger, and that was 40 plus minutes. So yeah, it's going to be that plus a lot more "we can't trust any of this information" disclaimers plastered all over it. With all that said, there is one part of this that is set into the entire community's mindset recently, and it's purely because of a line of audio that was playing in the dungeon, and, well, a little bit more that we're going to go over right now. And amazingly enough, it all starts with this.
"You know, when I walk the streets of the city, the children demand I carry them. I do so, but I ask them to sing me a song. A song of their people."
"No! I refuse."
"Then you can pay me. A titan is only as good as his word."
"But I don't know any songs."
"Make something up."
"Oh, let me see. Eris hummed a few bars on the moon. How did it go? I'm on the moon. It's made of cheese."
"That is awful."
"It's not my song. It's Eris's."
Yes, it starts with Shaxx's "I'm on the moon, it's made of cheese" song. Stay with me, I promise, there is an end to this that's much more serious than Shaxx singing really badly. So here's the thing, it's one of those moments where Shaxx says, "It's not my song, it's Eris's." Except, what if I told you that this wasn't Eris's song either? Savathûn apparently has her claws in this particular happening in the Destiny universe, and whilst that sounds ridiculous at first, hold your breath and listen to this dialogue between the Drifter and Eris from the Prophecy Dungeon, and this will explain a whole lot more.
"Hey, Three Eyes. Shaxx says you sang him a little ditty."
"What?"
"Shaxx, Chunky Titan, One Horn. Did you sing him a song on the moon?"
"What a senseless question."
"Yeah, I didn't think so."
"Stay off this channel. Should I need you, I'll call. Wait."
I didn't hang up."
"Does that oaf still keep that skull with him?"
"In the tower? Yeah, hangs it over his spot. I wouldn't have tangled with that thing."
"Desperate times. This lil' ditty, did it go?
That would be the one. What is it?"
"Savathûn's song. It's a viral chant. It can never be unheard. Now that Savathûn has announced herself, relics of the dark across the system have begun to awaken. Tell Shaxx to remove that skull immediately."
"Sister, I already tried."
"What did that oaf say?"
"No."
So this new revelation about the song Shaxx has been singing is really worrying. To explain the skull above him, yeah, simply look at where he is in the tower and you'll see the skull of what is presumed to be an Ahamkara above him in the nets. For those of you that don't know, Ahamkara have a special property that means even if they're dead, they can still whisper to you and, to a certain extent, can still actually do wish magic, which is pretty terrifying if you think about things. And the crazy thing about this is we may have a record of this dragon being killed and how Shaxx might have come across this skull. And if so, Eris and Zavala were there. This is way back during the Great Hunt, and I say might because the details of this leave an inconclusive end to the fate of the dragon's body. You'll understand that in a moment. Keep in mind that the Great Hunt was also very early in the City Age or very late in the Dark Age. The record is kept in the grips of the Great Hunt lore, and it reads as follows. "I wish to be precise. Venus, a year into the Great Hunt. Eris and Zavala watched as Shaxx sat with the dying Ahamkara, a hand on its snout. Is he gloating?" she asked. "I think he's too pragmatic to gloat," Zavala said. "Mourning, then. Perhaps." The Ahamkara twitched, its eyes rolled up into its head. The biochemical glow just beneath its skin grew harsh, Zavala and Eris raised their hands against the increasing glare. Then, the corpse exploded. Dirt showered the guardians like dusty rain on a clear day. Shaxx sat silently in the resulting crater, covered in a sheet of green fire. Zavala and Eris opened their mouths to speak, but Shaxx interrupted them. "Shh," he said, as the flame quietly roared. They could all hear a disembodied whisper, but they were used to that by now. So maybe this isn't the same dragon skull that Shaxx has put in the tower, especially given the explosion, but it's a little bit nondescript. The flame could have taken the skull of the beast with it, or it could have left it and only taken the flesh, so to speak. And regardless, even if the Ahamkara are just dust and aren't even bones, they can still communicate. Hence why, regardless of the fate, they all heard a disembodied whisper. However, no matter what happened, and whether this is the dragon or not, Shaxx has an Ahamkara skull above him in the tower, and it's probably been whispering to him a lot. It may not have been the skull that put the viral chant in his head, but it is definitely still dangerous. Here's the thing though, we've heard this viral chant long before the quest to recover the Devil's Ruin. We heard this viral chant back at the very beginning of Shadowkeep. Take a listen to Eris humming the tune, and then to a certain piece of menu music that, for those of you who've been playing over the last year, will sound very similar. Savathûn has been spreading this chant since literally the start of Shadowkeep, and the crazy thing about this is it fits into a lot of what she's done before. We know that this is one of her tactics, and we can even see the results of those tactics in real time, and that's all thanks to the Season of Opulence, and in particular, thanks to Galran. Galran wore the Crown of Sorrows, and as a result, was infected with a viral language which was planted within the crown by Savathûn herself. She has most definitely used these kinds of tactics before as a result, and the effects have been pretty terrible. Galran took control of the Hive aboard Kallus' Leviathan, and in particular the Hive in the lower decks within the Menagerie, and he basically sent them to fight against Kallus' loyalists and the Guardians that were under Kallus' employ at the time. Even with Kallus predicting this subterfuge and refusing to wear the crown himself, it was still a moment of dire consequence. If Savathûn's viral chant has infected us, the Drifter, Eris, Lord Shaxx, and also Saint 14, then we were in a great deal of trouble indeed. It's possible that when Witch Queen rolls around, there is a moment where Savathûn may be able to take this viral chant and weaponize it against all those who have heard it. It cannot be unheard, according to Eris, and so as a result, I would look to steer clear of any Guardian who has heard it. Which means maybe only a few Guardians in all of Destiny. We might perhaps be protected somehow by some ulterior force, maybe Toland could step in, but I really do feel like this is one of the methods by which Savathûn might weaponize us against each other. Such is her way. She is one for deception. She is one not to fight directly, but instead to pull her enemies apart using subterfuge. And as a result, we should be careful. Do not necessarily trust Savathûn's words, because perhaps this is simply made to plant distrust within our ranks. But if it is a weapon that she can mobilize against us, then the consequences may be disastrous. But that's all from me for now. If you enjoyed this video, go ahead and leave a like and let me know what you think in the comments section down below. And of course, if you want more Destiny content, go ahead and hit the subscribe button and the bell next to subscribe to turn on those email notifications. But with all that said, know that your viewership is quite enough for me. And in the meantime, my name has been, my name is Bife. Horodacia Arastra. I'll see you, Starside.